Hello everybody, once again, this is AikawaKazu and welcome back! Welcome back guys to another 7 nights video. It's pretty fast, right? It will not be daily, don't worry guys, it's just that because I'm new to the game, you know, and I'm eager to share with you guys some of the stuff that I'm working on, and especially those people who are actually new, who are trying it out after you watch my video, you'll probably be asking yourself the same questions when you come to this stage or even before you reach this particular stage of the game, where you're about close to 2 weeks into the game. I'm about 2 weeks into the game, just 2 days short of 2 weeks. So what we're gonna talk about today, I was trying to get at my thoughts, bad hair day guys by the way, is that we're gonna do fusion as well as rank up or evolution, that kind of stuff. So what it means is like how you get a unit from 3-star to 4-star and so on and so forth. So we're gonna do it today in this video. You can do it, right? And I'm gonna be showing you guys, I mean I'm gonna be gonna try and 6-star my Kris, as well as getting my Shane, maybe my Nia to 5 stars, but Shane to 5 stars definitely. I am pretty ready here because I didn't mention it in my previous video, but right now there's actually an event going on. How do I check the event? I think it's called, where was the thing? Yes, notification notice, yes. So it's really a good time to play 7 nights right now because of the New Year check-in event. So I didn't show this on the video yesterday, but basically you just need to log in on this particular day and you'll get a lot of good stuff. So most of you guys who are new to the game are gonna miss the first half of it already. Today is the 14th of January. We get 50,000 gold today. So you still have a 6-star item ticket, you still have a 3-star element ticket, you still have a 4-star hero ticket, 6-star weapon ticket, 6-star 7 nights item ticket. And this Transcender Fina, I have no idea what this is actually. But there's still a lot of good stuff for you to do and it'll really help you out, especially the keys for people who are new to the game. Make sure this is a very good time. Alright. I actually joined like before the first day. Nicole actually, or Liz joined on the first day, she got a 5-star hero. I think I joined on the 4th or the 5th. Yeah. So the other thing I want to talk about is, yeah, I'm very surprised that a lot of you guys actually added me. Like, I didn't know there were so many people, so many of my viewers actually playing this game. So remember in a previous video I showed that I only have 3 or 2 friends. Today I have 15, so 13 of you guys actually added me, and I'm pretty sure there's gonna be more after this video as well as time goes by. So I have another 85 slots while slots last, I guess. Okay, let's get to it. So because of the event, I managed to get a 4-star element selector ticket and a 4-star element ticket. So 4-star element ticket, you cannot choose what you're gonna get, alright? Selector means you can choose which element you want. And why do you need this? I'll talk about it very soon. But let's see what 4-star ticket I'm gonna get here. Not the best. Not the best. Okay, I'll talk about it. And this one, I'm gonna be choosing the fire one, because Shane is a fire element type. And I already got the required element for my Kris. So I'm gonna get the 4-star fire element. So this is what I'm gonna talk about here. It's what we call rank up. Okay. So there's a few ways to actually get a hero of a higher rarity. For example, what you can do is, if you look at my characters here, or you look at the left side here, look at my Kris. My Kris is currently plus 5, correct? Black-hearted Kris, plus 5. So whenever you get a unit to level 30, and you get him to plus 5, you can actually rank him up, alright? Depending on if the higher rank version of him exists. Of course, if you get a monster that doesn't have a higher rank unit of its current existing rank, then he cannot go up. But of course Kris can go up to 6-star and actually can 6-star him. So I need to remove him from everything. And you realize that you can change leader as well. Okay, so you realize that I have this right now. So I'm not gonna do this right now. Look at that, it costs 100,000 gold. But in this way, you will ensure that you get the same unit. So ranking up there's no RNG involved. When you rank up a unit, you're gonna get back the same unit, but at a higher rank. That means from 4-star to 5-star, 5-star, 6-star, and a 5-star unit will require a 5-star element to rank up. And you do not need the fusion or the evolution material, material to be level 30. It can be level 1. So I can actually rank him up right now, but I'm not gonna do it because the beginner quest, one of the last beginner quests, the guide beginner quest here, requires you to get a 5-star hero to 6-star. So now that I have my Shane, I can get my Shane to 5-stars and then get her to plus 5, so I can complete this and then do the relevant quest So unlock the get a hero to 6-star thing, then I'll get my Kris to 6-star. So let me show you my Shane here. Alright, but before we get to that, let's talk about another way to actually get a unit to a higher rarity. So let me see if I can show you guys right now. Do I have a level 30 3-star unit? I think I don't have. I've probably fed it away. Okay. Wait a minute, I have a level 30 copper. Let me see if I got... Okay, I got level 30 bat. Okay, I can show you guys here. So, I'm just going to show you guys using this method. I just want to feed the wrong unit away. So I'm going to get this level 30 guy to plus 5 very easily here. Oh, I'm going to waste some of the units. Yes. It's fine, guys. I'll take it. And this guy, I guess. Okay, so this guy's plus 5, right? So he's level 30, he's plus 5, and then I need to get another guy to level 30 plus 5. Which is, let's pick this Jazz guy. Let's power him up again. I'm wasting some units here. Like, I'm over ranking it, but whatever, it's cool. So you realize that I have 2 plus 5 right now. So I can do a fusion. Alright, so fusion allows you to get a random unit of the next rarity if you add both of the same rarity, they are level 30 and plus 5. So the two units need to be level 30 and plus 5, and when you fuse them, you can get the next rarity. Look at this. Upon successful fusion, new hero acquired is random, and it's 100% chance. So you do that, you will get a 2-star unit. Alright, of course this is not... Oh, wow, I got a 2-star Karin. I actually don't have her, so I can get 5 rubies from that. Which is pretty cool. I don't actually have a 2-star Karin before, or Karin. So, you don't want to do that on 2-star or 1-star units. Ideally, you know, what you want to do is you want to get a 3-star unit to level 30 and then get him to plus 5. Get another 3-star unit to level 30 and plus 5, and then you do fusion to try to get a 4-star. And most of the time, you're going to get monsters, but sometimes you might get lucky. You might get, I believe you are, it's possible to get a 7 knight or any... a 4-star unit that is available, just a random 4-star unit. So whenever you have a level 1 or a 3-star unit, get him to 30, get her or him to plus 5. Even it can be a monster, and then get 2 of those people, fuse it, and then get a random 4-star. And it works the same for 4-star, 5-star, and yeah, 4 and 5-star. So you get 2 4-star level 30 plus 5, fuse it, you get a random 5-star. And if you get 2 level 30 5-star units plus 5, and then you fuse them, you can get a random 6-star. So it works both ways, alright? It works both ways. I mean, that's not both ways. It works all the way up, alright? So right now, what we're going to do here is we're going to do rank up, not the fusion method, which is our Shane here. Going to remove Shane. And I have the material right now, so I can rank her up. Get that 4-star fire element. Okay, before I get to that, the question you have for me right now, right, is like, how are you going to get all these element materials? I know I got it through the event, alright? So where do you actually get these element selectors? So you go to adventure and you have this daily dungeon, and every day there's a different element selector or element that you can actually get at the end of the daily dungeon. Unfortunately, for most of the beginners here, that means if you're a 1-week account, even currently I have difficulty doing normal mode. So in easy mode you can only get 2 stars. It means the rarity of the element is only 2 stars, and in normal is 3 stars. And I'm not too sure if you can do hard yet. I'm not too sure how this is unlocked or is this available yet. But basically today I can actually try to farm a 3-star dark element, which is why I chose the fire one first, because I can actually get the material needed for Nia today. And I don't want to wait until tomorrow to rank up my Shin, because I want to do this video ASAP. And you can only do it once a day. So again, just like heroes or element units, alright, can also be ranked up. So I've actually prepared a 2-star dark element here plus 5, and you can rank him up using a 2-star level 1 plus 0 2-star dark element by running the easy one, and then I got a 3-star, right? And with 2 3-stars, I can level one of them to level 30 plus 5, which is, I've prepared this guy already, he's not plus 5 yet, and I can get a 4-star dark element selector, and then I can get my Nia to 5 stars. So I've actually prepared everything very nicely beforehand, alright? So it's not that I like Shane more, I like Nia as well, just that Nia is covered, guys. I got Nia covered. So right now we're gonna rank up our Shane. So that's how you actually get your element selector through the daily dungeons, alright? And You can pay rubies to do more, eat more than once a day. So again, rubies are pretty easy to farm. If you want, if you're in a hurry, you get, you just got a unit that you want to rank up fast, then maybe you can use rubies to run it again, that kind of stuff. But by default, you can only run it once a day. And make sure that you have enough gold as well, because you realize that ranking up on 5 to 6 star costs 100,000 gold actually, and 4 to 5 is 50,000. So let's get Shane to 5 stars here. And somehow she becomes older, and then when she reaches 6 stars, she's younger again. You realize, right? Now she's like a grandma. Now she's like a grandmother. But yeah, she's still one of my favorite characters in this game so far, in terms of how she looks. I like her portrait here. It's damn nice. Alright, so now that we got her to level, I'm going to power her up. This is how you get her to plus 5. And I have some fodders here, I believe. I'm feeding this. Feeding this by Aaron. So getting her to plus 5 will help me complete my quest. Should I have fed that droopy? Oh shit, I think I should have fed the droopy. Was it a spare droopy? Oh no! I think I might have made a mistake here. Oh shit, I just fed my droopy away! Actually, yeah, and she was level 30, you guys. We lost! Mistakes have been made. Okay, now I'm just feeding 3 stars away. Wait, did I overfeed? Let me check. Okay, I didn't overfeed, so I should fed my droopy away, guys. Kazu failed highlight. Dude, droopy is also another hero that looks very pretty. Have a look at a 3-star version. Wait, wrong character. I fed my... No, she's still here, guys! Chill! Mistakes were not made, guys. My level 30 4-star droopy was still here. That was a spare one. Chill, guys. Chill. Chill. We didn't lose. That was close. That was close. Okay, I got my Shane to 5 stars. That means that I've completed my guide quest. Oh, I got a 4 star Baron here. And now I need to do this. Yeah, this is like the Fueler quest. And okay, let's get my... Okay, so let me share with you guys some of the maps that I actually grind at the start. I know when you are all decked out and stuff, if you go to Reddit and if you Google, I know that I think some people farm at 8-2 or something. But when I was still a scrub, alright, you can clear all your quests until you reach normal 110, alright? Normal 110 is pretty good if you want to spend some keys and you want to level some units to level 30. Just for rubies, it's pretty nice to farm. But one problem is that the boss is immune to physical damage because of this Swift Rider shit. It's very annoying. So if you do not have magical base attackers, I wouldn't recommend this stage. But I farmed like easily 50 to 60 keys on this stage, and then after which I found a better one, which was 2-10 for normal mode. And these guys are just very tanky. Yeah, they reduce damage by and they increase defense. So right now I'm using 2-10 normal mode, even though for hard I'm actually at like quite far. I'm down to like, I can go further, I think. It's just that I haven't bothered to go further. So I'm at 4 right now. So but since we're gonna level Shane up, we're gonna do 2-10. And yeah, now we're just gonna chill together. I want to make my videos a bit, you know, more lighthearted. So this is... Hope 7 Nights can be a start of that, and I try to make the videos to be around 30 minutes long. Yep. So, okay, so this is actually my... I'm actually leveling the units up here as well. This Harpy, I didn't level her before. And let's get my Shane in. So I do this to level up monsters. And usually people just bring two units, like two maxed out units to farm, like you can level three units at one go. But I played safe. I bring my Nia, my Shane and my Kris. But I think when my Kris is 6-star, I can just bring two, that kind of stuff. Nate, did you try Warframe or Money or something? Yep, I did, and I got motion sickness. I'm serious. I had very bad motion sickness that last until yesterday. Just being frank here. I don't know why, I turned off like motion blur and I put the maximum FOV but I got motion sickness. I don't know why. Queen is like laughing. So So you see, Shane is so strong. She's only level 10 and she's critting as hard as she was like when she was a 4-star. I think today they nerfed like the dragons as well, the raids. Maybe later I can show you guys. So what we're gonna do this video is, will I do 10? I think I'm going to like cut out the farming of the 10 runs kind of stuff on the video itself. But we'll do some arena, and then if you get a raid, we'll do a raid. They nerfed the dragon raids today. Yeah. I don't get motion sickness from CSGO. I only get motion sickness from like Warframe. And I remember Dying Light. It is the FOV problem. Wait. I just need like the character cannot be too close to my screen, pretty much. So I'm actually streaming this right now, and if you want to check out my stream, I stream every day around 7 PM, Singapore time of course, GMT plus 8 time zone. And I stream for 5 or 6 hours every time. And 7 Nights will be the game that I'll be playing for the first 1 or 2 hours every time. So if you want to catch some of the 7 Night players in my stream chat, or you just want to come here and have a good time, you know, you can just come along. The links is in the description below. And I stream every day except for Sundays. So we call our stream the 100% positive stream and chat, and we are pretty proud of it, where you seldom see trolls in the chat. Even if they are trolls, they are 100% positive trolls, that kind of stuff. We are usually nice people, unless you're an asshole yourself, then you might be not very well liked by the chat, that kind of stuff. I'm getting the Kraken Sample White Chroma tomorrow, 50% off. Oh, I'm getting the Death Adder Chroma. I should be getting it. Because I'm not very happy with my current mouse. I'm hoping the Death Adder is gonna be good. Right, yeah, guys, there's actually a Razer Insider kind of thing, because they won the what? CES? Razer won the CES award or something, and they are, you know, giving back to their fans by having a 50% off sale on their accessories and peripherals in around 16 hours from this timing. Depending on your vision, the timing is different, so make sure you go Google it, it's very fast. There's a mod for FOV for Warframe. Oh. Man, bad hair day. Bad hair day, guys. Alright, so I got this element at level 30 already. So, you'll see the 5 rubies. So, let me know in the comments, man. How long have you guys been, you know, playing 7 Nights? I know the game has been out for at least 3 months or so, probably more. I know there's a global server, I'm not too sure when the Asia server actually came out. I actually thought I'm playing the global server, but apparently I'm playing the Asia server, so I'm very confused right now. And I believe there's actually a Thai server, because when I was googling for like images for thumbnails for YouTube videos when I was doing my first video, I saw some images with, you know, Thai words on it, so I believe there's a Thai exclusive server for 7 Nights. Yep. I tried 7 Nights a few days ago, I didn't like auto attack. Either that or the gameplay felt too simple. All mobile games will be too simple for you, Queen. Come on. You know, come on. Mobile games are not meant to be complicated. You know? That's the sad truth. That's the sad truth. Like, even when I played Crusader Quest previously, you know, it's nominated as one of the top strategic mobile games that's out last year. Like, I believe there's some awards that's been given out in 2p.com, the website or something, and basically yeah, Crusader Quest have a lot of strategy into it, but you will come to a point where, you know, you wouldn't really care so much, because it cannot be more complicated than that. People who play mobile games don't want it to be complicated, they want it to be pretty straightforward. So I think the direction that many, you know, mobile games are taking when it comes to the gameplay, right, instead of making it like harder to play, like more complicated to play, they're just adding more stuff. Like if you look at 7 Nights right now, I think one very cool thing is, you know, they have raids, they have guild versus guild, they have arena, they have castle rush, they have celestial tower. So they're just, you know, if they are bored of grinding or the story, yeah, just go to celestial tower. Celestial tower, you know, it's like TOA in and summoner walls, I believe. The higher floors, like floors 50 to 100, you need some kind of strategy, you need some form of specific unit, some form of debuffer, some buffer, you know, some immunity, that kind of stuff. So that's like a level of depth within one side of the gameplay itself. And talking about summoner walls, today I just got my tail mask, alright? So those who play summoner walls will know what I mean. It is my first guild war, you know, fragment. I finally collected 10 stacks to summon my Ifrit, and I got tail mask. Liars, guys, liars. One try, and tail mask is the one that you want to get. Even though in the end you want to try to get all three, like you want to get Amir. I think Amir is the fire guy, right? And you want to get the other one as well. But tail mask, man. With tail mask, I can progress a lot faster in summoner walls as well. And talking about luck, alright, talking about luck, Nicole, alright, got a fire monkey king, alright, she got a monkey king, a net 5, you know, she just YOLO'd one mystical scroll and she got a monkey king. It's crazy, it's insane. I haven't gotten a net 5 yet on my Asia like account for summoner wars. Hopefully I get one soon. But that's summoner wars. In the end, I'm not cutting the 10 games out. As I mentioned, I'm trying to be have a very casual, conversational setting kind of video for 7 nights. And just chill and talk about stuff. Mobile games are designed to be simple, addicting, and to convince the user to spend. No. I think it's both sides, Senpai. Like, I have as I mentioned, I'm streaming this right now, so one of my viewers mentioning that mobile games is designed to be simple and addicting. I would say, in a sense, of course they want you to continue to play, right? But I think the difference is what draws you in compared to, you know, some games are just straight up in your face, kind of addicting kind of thing. I don't know if you guys know what I'm trying to talk about, what I'm trying to say, but some games are more subtle and more up to your like preference or your choice or the stuff that you like. I wouldn't say that Seven Nights is addicting. Like, I think I was watching YDCB make a video about Seven Nights, and after watching that video, I didn't want to play Seven Nights. Like, yeah, I wasn't like, okay, the graphics is okay. The gameplay seems to be a bit, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on, debuff duration minus, you know, lethal, critical, speed attack. It's a bit overwhelming when I first saw it. Immunity, and it's not all shown very nicely. Like, look at my Shane right now. You don't know what's the icon on top of her right now, correct? Like, you wouldn't actually be able to guess unless you actually play the game, like you go read up her skills, that kind of stuff. So the UI is not very clean as well. I mean, this is just being frank, but it's a mobile game, you know, and it's a different art style that the Korean developers want to go for. So I wouldn't say that the game actually drew me in right off the start. And in my previous video, I mentioned that the main driving factor for me playing this game is Nicole's playing. And let's put it this way, I think if you have a girlfriend as well, your girlfriend will actually, you know, introduce you to things that you perhaps don't like. For example, I never liked to eat sashimi. Like, I never liked to eat sashimi because it was raw. And I wasn't a fan of salmon. And I always think that the idea of eating raw food is, you know, a bit disgusting, you know. So in the end, I don't like salmon. My girlfriend's like, you know, this is the best thing, you should try it. If you try it just one time, you'll love it. I tried salmon, sashimi, I'm like, oh my goodness. Now I go to buffets or buffets just to eat salmon. And I mean, the last time I did it was quite a while ago because it's, you know, very fattening and kind of stuff. But point is, she made me learn to like to eat things that I didn't like. So for Seven Nights, all games that I play is pretty similar as well. And she's playing Seven Nights. I tried it. I kind of liked it. So it's pretty cool. Nate, I started to fall in love with salmon recently. I think as you grow older, right, you learn to appreciate, you know, the things that you wouldn't think you'll like, you know. It's true, right? Like, I don't know, maybe if you let a young guy, like a boy, eat, you know, try beer, he'll be like, ugh, this thing is so bitter. You know, young kids usually like sweet things. I think beer can be, I would say beer is sweet as well. I don't know. But you wouldn't like those things at a young age. Like, people don't like to eat bitter gourd at a young age. I didn't like to eat bitter gourd as a vegetable when I was young. But now I love to eat bitter gourd. you know. It's like as you grow older, somehow the things that are more bitter or I would say more unique seems to, you know, pique your interest more compared to when you're young. This is starting to sound like a pedophile talking to me. Come on, Quinn, come on. Casual man, casual video guys. Casual video. Okay, my shit is almost 30, that's cool. I need to do 10 of this adventures. How many have I done? Oh. So it's pretty cool, you know, they actually bring you to the menu first. Like, they could be a joke and make you just start up the run straight away and you lose the key even though you got a person of 30. But they will actually bring you out and see, all these guys got badges already. Alright, this guy doesn't have a badge yet, so we'll get him to 30. But yep, I think I'm actually very appreciative of the support you guys have for the previous video that I did for 7 Nights. I'm actually pretty surprised about the response. So thank you. Thank you. Hopefully we get to rally more people, you know. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the videos. Hopefully you guys are enjoying this casual or casual conversation that we're having right now. So put it on stream. But yes! Actually, I'm supposed to talk about this at the start of the video, but you know, my stream is 100% positive, right? Positive. So I didn't want to talk about it, okay? If you realized, right, in almost every video that I uploaded until today, ever since I quit Dragoness, Kazu, come back to Dragoness, Kazu, I'll never give up, come back, hashtag, come back to Dragoness, Kazu. You know, Koki, I know, I wouldn't say you have been the guy that have been asking me to come back or asking me if I'm still playing, that kind of stuff. There are some people that fought that I'm still playing, which is, you know, I've quit for more than 8 months already. It's gonna be almost 1 year since I quit. But I will never go back. Maybe Dragoness 2. If Dragoness 2 is even coming out, alright. But I'm not going back, okay? I'm just gonna sum it up in a very, very simple reason. Throw away, okay, take away what I hate about the game. Throw away what I don't like about the developers or the publisher, what they're doing, you know, they're just wasting the game. That's why I'm very angry, that kind of stuff. Let's take all the negativity away. The reason why I'm not gonna go back to play Dragoness is because it's the same thing. Alright? I've played the game excessively for 24 cap, 32 cap, 40 cap. I even played the Taiwan version when Dragoness first came out. Alright, if you didn't know. In China, when it first came out, not Taiwan, it's not China, but when it first came out in Taiwan, Dragoness first came out in Taiwan, I played Dragoness when it was already there, and I waited like 2 years before it came out in Southeast Asia. And before that, I already played it. I played 24, 32, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. 7 caps! Alright! 7 caps of raids, dragons hardcore, you know, starting from Sea Dragon all the way. I've completed my Dragoness package, okay? I even shortcasted PV, I've done my ladder series, I've played everything that the game can offer me. There's nothing else left in the game that excites me anymore. I mean, Red Dragon, I mean, yeah, it's a new dragon, new mechanics, but essentially it's the same. You need to farm the same gear, you know. And I don't want to go back to that. And the most important thing is the RNG of the game is still there, alright? And don't even talk about the class discrimination, the new classes that are coming out, all that kind of bullshit, alright? I'm not going back! It's just not gonna happen! Alright, unless they fix the problem, alright? And a lot of people ask me why I quit. Okay, it's very simple, okay? The game, for you to enjoy the game, I mean, okay, you just ask 80% of the playbase, I will say even more, alright? If they could have a full FD character with maximum critical or the most optimal build that their class can have, like if they can actually get to that stage within 3 months or 4 months or even let's say half a year, okay, 100% chance to get to that stage within half a year before the next level cap comes up. Alright, if there is an option that is present and fair for everyone out there who plays Dragoness, whichever class you play, okay, I'm talking about the skill, talking about the enhancement heraldry's third stats, okay. If you know that you grind for X number of Ness or X number of Dragons, okay, that you can get this third stat enhancement heraldry so that you can build the ideal stat build for your character and your class so that you can enjoy the game. I mean, okay, look at this. everyone, let's take Moonlord, alright, let's take Moonlord for example. Everyone wants to do like fucking 5 million Moonblade dance or whichever the cap, you know, whatever is the crazy full FD damage. Like everybody watches like 50,000 views of some guy full FD, Moonlord, solo, Black Dragoness, Memorial, Stage 2. Why? Because everyone likes to see the damage. If I really wanted to be a view whore, which I have done in the past, I just put a Gladiator 750,000 damage and BAM! That video has 150,000 views. Why? Because people like to see min and max. And you don't see me do that kind of videos anymore because I'm not that kind of person. I don't want to make videos that are encouraging people to play the game because they want to get to that stage. But unfortunately, the fundamental thing about the game is if you ask 80% of the player base, everyone wants to get there. Everyone wants to be full FD someday. Like, you have a PvP player like Aces who have never gone full FD in 40, 50 cap, suddenly bam, 60, 70 cap, I want to go full FD. Because everyone wants to try it once. And I have done the poor man's FD before. You see, I have done the poor man's FD before. So, I have finished the whole Dragonite package. So, until the developers wake up and know that that's their game! They don't even understand that people, that is endgame for the players. And the endgame is not possible. Because it's all RNG. When you craft an enhancement heritage plate, you can craft 50 enhancement heritage plate and you will not get a 3rd step FD. Maybe you're just cursed with fucking 3rd step paralyzed all day and what, you quit your game? You know how frustrating is that to a player? They made a game that is fun, but they don't allow people to enjoy the fun part about the game. You see? And that's how the game is being built. And it's very simple. All they need to do is to come out, I mentioned this before, a token system, alright? You complete 7 nest runs every day with your 5 normal and your 2 health, you get one of these tokens. So that's 1 week, right? So this guy needs to get 5 tokens or 4 tokens, he needs to do it for 4 weeks. With 4 tokens, I can exchange 100% chance a 3rd stat heritage plate that I want. Hell, if you want to give the guy FD, then make him get 8 tokens. So that's fucking 2 months. But at least at the end of 2 months, he can get 1 3rd stat FD plate that he wants. That simple! But no! They don't know! And you look at their game, it's just... And people are asking me, Kazu, you must go back to Dragonlance, man. And the people that want me to go back is for a very simple reason. They know that the game is dying. They need Kazu back. They need Kazu to do videos again. So that people are hyped up about the game again, people come back. But when I go back, all I see is PvP imbalance. PvE, all same thing all over again. And just a game that I've as I mentioned, I've gotten a full package already. I've done the raids at a specific level cap. I've cleared, thanks to Frizzy and his group of party members that I'll never forget. I cleared Hardcore Black Dragon and Normal Black Dragon at the level cap it was released. And when you have done that in Dragon Age, BAM! It's done! So many people have quit the game once they have hit full FD and have done that. Because that's the most satisfying thing the game can offer to you, to be honest. And once you have done that, people quit. I mean, look at the people that have done it in Desert Dragoness. People like, I won't mention names, but people who have done it have already quit in that cap, alright? They have quit longer than me. So, I have done my endgame thing and there's nothing else the game offers. Just imagine for a moment that if they did what I did about the token system, if I've done it, if I have a full FD Moonlord character that I've, you know, fruitfully farmed for 4 months, and I'm a fucking hardcore player, I will bother to actually even get full FD for another character so that I can do another video on a character or just have fun with that another character. And even if they come out with OP characters, at least I can gear up that OP character, you know, that kind of stuff. Now, I can farm up a character and BAM! Next day it's nerfed to hell and it's just shit. And I wasted six months. And for some people, they wasted $4,000 to $6,000 to get full FD plates. So, don't ask me to go back, okay? I'm done! I'm done with that game, guys. I am done with that game, okay? Please! Please! Don't ask me to go back, okay? Rant over, guys. It's supposed to be a casual video. But, you know, it's kept inside me for a long time. Maybe I should just do one video dedicated to that. Like, I should just cut it out and put why I'm not going back to Dragoness. Just cut out from the video. In any case, okay, let's continue this video. We need to get a 6-star hero from rank up. So let's do that, because we can actually rank up our Kris right now, and that's awesome! Kris, let's go! 100,000 gold gone, but 6-star Kris. So basically, right? Okay, this is the part I find very funny, okay? They have completed the guide quest. Oh, I need a speed attack. Oh, this is the perfect item for my Kris. Reach level 30, see, that's the thing. The beginner guide quest actually kind of flows very well. So try to go with the flow, guys. Try to go with the flow. Okay, what did I want to do? Yes, I want to change the weapon. This is actually such a waste though. I'm gonna spend 5 topaz. I'm gonna do it. Because topaz can be earned from PvP, and I have 10. I think 10 is still enough for costumes, right? Shit. Yeah. 10 is still enough for costume, guys. We can still get our bunny costume for shit if we want. In any case, let's get the new weapon in for. Yeah. Okay, so there's actually like specific stats that you should go for specific heroes or specific 7 knights, and speed attack is the best for Kris apparently. And I believe lethal attack is the best for Shane, so I actually want to transfer my Shane this item, which is why I bothered to. Oh my goodness. It's a 4-star sword. But you want to put lethal attack on Shane because Shane has a passive that increases her crit rate already, so she's not worried about crit rate at all, so. And I will do it in another video, guys. But let's have fun with our Shane here. Let's have fun with our Shane. And yeah, let's just do one more run here. And we should be done with this video. Come on. He's only level 1 though, I don't think he can one-shot this. But anyway, I didn't finish what I wanted to show, okay? Is that when Shane was 4-star, right, he was like a nice little guy. Then when he reached 5-star, he wear a mask. And then 6-star, it just takes away the mask. Got a Guild War winner costume, quits DN again. Oh yeah, Hashi's Guild actually won the previous Guild War event or something, if I remember correctly. Man, see, I'm so dazed after I finished the rant about Dragoness. You know, like, I haven't been watching a lot of Dragoness videos because even after I've quit it for more than a year, if I watch like a Moonlord video, right, that, I mean, just to be honest, that is the one thing to go back. Moonblade Nuts, until today, to me, alright, personally, this is like a personal touch, alright, Moonblade Dance will be one of the best animated skills in games that I've played. Alright. The little floaty feeling that it gives you when you jump up, and then, you know, if you watch Bleach, the sword waves coming out. That feeling is so awesome, and I thank Dragonite for that. And this is why, until today, or even until, you know, I die or something, my channel profile picture will always be my character. Like, even my Steam profile picture is my character, you know, kind of stuff. I will not forget Dragonite. And like, maybe some people think I'm grateful to, you know, Dragoness or something. That is the game that actually made me where I am today. I'm not. I love the game. If there's anyone out there that loves Dragoness more than me, I don't know. But I am definitely, you know, I confidently say that I'm one of those people that really, really love the game. One day, alright, I always mention this because I can't talk about it until next year or something. One day, you guys will know how much I've done for the game, and when that happens, it won't matter anymore. But I've done so much for this game. I've done all I could for Dragoness. And one day, or maybe one day no one will ever know it. I don't care if people knows about it. But I can talk about it next year, because NDA, guys. 2 years NDA. So one day, people will know, and they will know that actually many of the things that you see in the game, or some of the things that you see in the game, could have been there or not there because of someone. That's all I can say. Obviously that someone is not me. But yeah, one day people will know, but by then I think the game's already dead. Maybe there's gonna be Dragoness 2. You know, I talk about it on stream. Maybe one day Steam, aka Valve, will really realize how special Dragoness combat system is and just take it and, you know, make it to a standalone game. You know. Maybe, just maybe. That is something that I always... It's like a miracle, guys. Maybe it will happen, maybe it will not happen. Maybe some guy will recognize how good Dragoness is. And, you know, give it the deserving, you know, recognition that it should have. Even until today, how many years already? 4 or 5 years? Even more than that, right? I think more than 5 years that Dragon Nest has been released. There is no game out there that has the combat system as good as Dragon Nest. Some people say that Warframe has it, but it's different. Like, Warframe is very smooth, but it doesn't give you the same feeling as Dragon Nest. That same free-flowing feeling. I would say a relative free-flowing feeling, because Warframe gives you that free-flowing feeling, but you know, it doesn't translate into the gameplay itself. Like, the impact of the actions doesn't translate to... Like, your free-flowing movement doesn't really translate into the gameplay itself. Something like that. And, like, people mentioned, Warframe gameplay and Dragon Nest gameplay doesn't equate. Yeah, it's true. But I'm just saying that Dragon Nest gameplay, no one has... I mean, combat system, not gameplay. Dragon Nest combat system, no one is able to emulate that yet in a game. Maybe because they patent that shit, I don't know. Or maybe people don't know how they have done it. But thing is, it's so good. And yep, I think that should bring us to... Oh yeah, we want to do a bit of arena, right? But I need to get my Shane to level 30, and I think this video is more than 30 minutes already. This thing's just above 30 minutes. I think we'll keep it that way, so... We'll do arena in our next video. Oh yeah, just one last thing. The reason why I'm doing stages like 210 and 110 instead of the other stages is because if you look at quest, alright, this is like achievement quest. There's this thing called Great Adventurer and Public Enemies. Right now I'm quite far in already, but basically you can earn a lot of rubies from this achievement. Like, look at this, defeat a normal monster in adventure mode, defeat a boss monster. So when you do 210 and 110 normal mode, you'll kill 2 boss monsters. And basically if you run, how many, 20 runs, you'll get 40, right? But basically you can earn a lot of rubies just by running those boss stages. And as time goes by, the numbers actually increase, because the amount that you need to kill also increases as well. So it's good to get quick rubies, especially if you're new to the game. Just the last final thing before I end the video. But that's it guys, hope you guys enjoyed this 7 nights video. If you did, stomp the like button, and I hope you guys enjoy this more casual, conversational type video as well. Let me know in the comments, you know, the thing you remember about Dragon Nest, especially if you're one of those people that quit. And if you're gonna type, Kazu, please come back. I'm not coming back, bruh, I'm not coming back, alright, it's just not gonna happen, I'm so sorry. If not, thanks for watching once again, God bless, I'll see you guys and girls in the next video. Check out the stream if you want, I'm always around 7 PM, links in the description. And, yep, that's all guys. Goodbye.